And that is where babies come from. Any questions?
Actually, I was wondering where rabies come from.
Oh, well, I suppose that the stork could give you rabies too. Why do you ask?
Okay, thank you, Austin. Thank you very much for that terrific presentation. Okay, I guess that concludes our Tuesday meeting. As you know, I will not be out to take vacation. I will not be here tomorrow.
Oh,
well, you know, look, the county requires that we take one vacation a year, and I haven't done it in 3 years or so. So it's about time that I do it. Now, if you don't think you can handle it.
All right.
Well, I knew you. I didn't have to worry about you guys.
Yeah.
2 hours later.
Captain's log, star date 2745.3. I really miss Matt's eye. It's only been a day or two, and I don't know. I can't even take Captain's log without wondering if it's log base 2 or log base 10. Or the natural log. I wonder how they're doing. Oh, they're all right. Maybe I'll just check in.
Hello?
Hey, Bimba. How's everything going over there?
Oh, you know, it's fine.
Why are you out of breath?
Just a good calc test. This free response.
Oh, all right. Well, what I was going to say is, What? Is everything okay over there?
Fine. We couldn't handle it. When you left, things were fine for a while, but then they started to break apart. Freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and seniors. It was all fine, but my mentor used to tell me stories about when the coordinator would keep balance between the classes. But that all changed when chaos attacked. Only Mr. Burns, the head of Math Sci, could stop it. But when the specialty center needed him most, he vanished. One day passed.
Is that Avatar the Last Airbender?
Maybe.
Look, Bimba, this is serious. I don't need the whole story. I just need the awful movie M. Night Shyamalan version, okay?
Mr. Burns, Math Sci has been divided by zero. Hello?
Did you guys know that a Swatch Watch Bimba?
Wow, I'm really glad to see you all. What's going on here?
Well, when the chaos struck, we came in here for refuge. We thought it was only going to be temporary, but we've been here for 3 periods.
I heard that the other teachers are hiding in Mr. Johns' room. Well, except for Dr. E.
And we're going to call that I. How many are taking calculus? Good.
What are we going to do now?
I'm sure you know why I've assembled you together today.
Actually, we do not.
Wait, what are you doing here? I asked for the best of the best.
Oh, well, everyone else is at an NHS meeting. We were the only ones that went busy.
Well, I guess you'll have to do. Math Sci is crumbling. It's a shadow of its former self.
Really? You could have fooled me.
Everything I see is chaos. I'm leaving it to you guys to end that chaos.
Well, Mr. Burns, I think we actually already have a plan.
You do? What is it?
You see, Math Sci is so chaotic, it's like a Harlem Shake that forgot to end. And how do you end a Harlem Shake?
You replace it with a new internet music video style sensation.
And I think we have just the internet music video style sensation. Slow walking.
This is a tardy sweep. Teachers, if you would, close your doors at this time. Students that are in the hallway, you are tardy in class.
One debt to society later.
Okay, so slow walking was a complete failure.
Yeah, it's almost like we spent the first half of our mission on a subplot that went absolutely nowhere.
Now we need a real plan. Does anyone have any ideas?
Well, I did hear about this rumor during my time in the slammer.
Stop saying the word slammer. You were in there for like 40 minutes.
Anything goes. We need ideas. Let's hear it.
Okay, so apparently the answer to the chaos can be found on the roof.
The roof? Where's that?
I know exactly where we need to go. Let's get started.
If Masai were a noise, what noise would it be?
For all you Harry Potter fans, a mandrake. I don't know what that is.
Miss Hunter's laugh.
Which Masai teacher would survive longest on a deserted island?
Probably Mr. Felt, because his voice would scare away everything. Last name is Johnson, because she would hear the bird calls and know what they're saying and know what the direction to go for safety.
Definitely Mr. B.
Yeah, probably
I
like
think
uproot
he's like
a tree.
Big enough to, yeah.
Get rid of the competitors.
Miss Clopton, because she's Miss Clopton.
What most distinguishes a Masai student?
In fact, we just talked about this. Mm. We were exercising in Miss Hunter's room, and I looked under the desk. There was no gum under the desk.
True. They don't chew gum.
The lack of ability to talk to females, and the gigantic backpack.
If it's physically, it's the size of their head. It's about this much bigger than the other student's head.
I think it's sass.
All things sass.
You know, the ability to understand sass, the ability to receive sass, be respectable with sass. The sass is real.
Hey, you guys want to get some bubble tea after this? I don't know what it is, but I really want to try it.
I got it. Which button do you think it is?
I don't know. Which button do you think it is?
There it is!
Roof! 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 Roof!
Guys, no way! It's Mr. Templeton!
Mr. Templeton?
Hello, my children.
I thought you left to do drugs.
No, you were close. I left to become a pharmacist.
So you're dealing drugs?
On a basic level, yes. But I sell physician-prescribed drugs. But that's not important. The truth is, I never really left you. I've had my eyes on Masai ever since I left, just in case I was needed again. Yes, I know all about your Masai is crumbling situation. It should be an easy fix.
Sir, I mean no disrespect, but I've been in those hallways. I've held the hand of a fellow student while their work ethic plummeted. I had to tell them that it would be all right and they would get into college, knowing full well that colleges want to see a steady or rising GPA and a broad range of extracurricular activities. And you're telling me it's easy!
Calm down, man, calm down! I'll handle this. Mr. Templeton, it's gotten so bad that Ms. Hunter's hair can't pick a style. There's no easy fix!
I guess the situation is worse than I thought. I guess my eyes have been out in the building for some time. Then this means we have no time to waste. Gentlemen, I'll be brief. You must find the source of the chaos.
Well, how are we gonna do that?
Luckily, we have almost had this happen to us before. You'll need to go to room 431. Look behind the honor code. I left a clue there a few years ago. Now go, hurry.
Why don't you just tell us where the source of the chaos is?
There's no time. You must go.
One more thing. Do you know photosynthesis?
Now isn't the time for that. Especially when a quarter of the people in the audience won't even understand that reference. Having said that, what do you think I've been doing all this time?
Glucose.
Oh,
need to end this before it gets any worse. Where's the honor code?
Wait, guys. What if the honor code's in here? In all of us?
If anyone has any real answers, that'd be useful right about now.
Don't patronize me.
What? I'm not patronizing you. We need to find out. Guys, look. Holy Bruce Ensley. Come on, let's take it down.
Clay, be careful.
You don't want to break the honor code.
Okay, well, let's turn it over. He said it would be on the back. Drat, I was afraid of this. He must have used invisible ink. And the only way you can see invisible ink is with lemon juice and a hairdryer.
Let me worry about the lemons.
Well, we have the lemons covered, but we still need a hairdryer.
I have a hairdryer.
Wait, have you guys been here this whole time?
Why do you have a hairdryer?
I always have a hairdryer.
It doesn't matter. Just all of you come over here and help us.
The answer to the chaos is what you desire, and going to Mr. Murr's office is what is required.
Whoa.
Well, that's pretty straightforward.
A riddle wouldn't be that obvious.
Wait, it's poetry. And poetry's English. Well, Masai's English classrooms. So the next clue must be in one of the English classrooms.
Well, let's go, quickly.
If Masai were an animal, which animal would it be?
I think a chameleon.
An elephant, because
it would be a rabid hyena, because y'all people are crazy.
A T-Rex, because...
Like Estefano.
Estefano, because they're like really ferocious and crazy, but then they have these little arms and they can't really do anything, and then they can't stand up, apparently.
If Masai were an article of clothing, which article of clothing would it be?
A onesie.
Probably like skinny jeans, because like it's really hard to get into, but once you do, it's tight.
If Masai were a white rapper other than Macklemore, Eminem, Vanilla Ice, or 50 Cent, who would it be?
Josh Willard.
DJ Lloyd Swag.
DJ L.A.
Yep.
I'd have to say Slim Sammy. Probably Tom Burrell.
If Masai were an antelope, what would it be?
Probably not an antelope. It would probably be to some random scientist in an antelope costume observing them to cure cancer.
It's locked.
What do we do now?
So hey, you guys are looking for a key.
That depends. Who's asking?
They call me the Keymaster.
You got the hookup?
Depends. You got what I need.
This enough for you?
It's all right. I'm also gonna need his tie.
My tie?
Yeah.
Why my tie?
Okay, come on, be reasonable.
Yeah, just give him the tie, Jason.
Hey, I don't even have a tie.
Fine. Come on.
It's been a pleasure doing business with you.
All right, gang, let's split up and search for clues.
Mr. T's writing portfolio.
He must have left this for us.
If you were reading this, then I left it for you. Obviously, Masai is in trouble, and although I can't possibly predict the specific problem, I can tell you that there is a reason Mr. Burns chose a conference room as his office. The conference rooms control everything. If someone wants to control the school, it'd start there.
What's in this before the chaos gets worse?
You don't deserve this. This is Italian.
No!
There it is.
All right, let's go. All right, one, two.
Okay, are we going on three or on go?
We're going on three.
Okay, I just wanted to clear it up. You know, it's kind of ambiguous.
Yeah, I thought we were gonna go on go.
Fine, we'll go on go.
Okay.
One, two.
What are you doing?
Oh, well, I don't wanna be rude. What if we were supposed to call first?
We're breaking in. We weren't invited.
Even more reason to call.
All right, I'm going in.
My word.
Vainu?
Well, 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 it took you long enough. But you're too late. Did you, Billo, really think you'd be able to stop my evil plans?
But why?
All I wanted to do was be a director, like Mr. Burns. But what did he do? He pushed me aside.
Go home, buddy. I work alone.
That's an incredible backstory.
When all I wanted to do was help. But now I've learned to help myself. Which is why I hacked into everyone's headlines and made it look like they were all failing.
You monster!
And I also took away all the batteries in the calculator.
How could you?
Why don't I just rip my heart out and send it to the organ donation store myself?
But there's one thing I can't figure out. Why didn't the headline changes affect you guys?
Well, we don't actually check headline. You know, we like to think positive.
My mom does, though. She's probably going crazy right now.
But doesn't matter. You guys are too late. Nothing can stop me now. Not you, not Mr. Burns. Maybe a high-powered lemon might be able to, but, like, you guys don't have that, so that's not gonna... Well, I bet you don't have to.
I forgot about buy one, get one free at the lemon store.
Okay, well, now that he's out of the way, we can just shut down his operation before it gets any worse.
Wait a minute. This looks like the standard lock switch computer game mega security system, TIE-5, Silver Edition.
My god, that's going to take forever to disable.
All I gotta do is override the mainframe and then...
Done.
Woo!
Yeah!
Mm. Yes! Yes! Mm. Yes!
Yeah!
Woo!
That was awesome.
But what do we do now?
Should we call Burns or something?
Mm-hmm.
Hey. Yeah, we did it.